Our night sky is full of stars. They look pretty there. But don't make a mistake, stars are one of the most violent places in the universe. They get their energy from the thermonuclear fusion and are capable of vaporizing hard thousands of times. But in this universe, nothing is permanent. At any point of time, while some stars are getting born, others are going to die. The fate of a star depends on its mass. While the high mass stars will probably become a black hole or a neutron star, the low mass stars, after they used up all its fuel, will glow for billions to trillions of years. These are white dwarf stars. Stars get their energy from the thermonuclear fusion at its core. The process is complicated, but in simple words, two hydrogen atoms collide to form a helium atom and some other stuffs along with a lots of energy. But to start a fusion process, you need lots of energy. The mass of a star is huge. The gravity contracts the hydrogen atoms at its core so densely that a fusion process can start. And this is the reason why stars glow but planet does not. In planets, as the mass is very low, gravity cannot start a fusion process. For most of the stars, fusion occurs in the core. But in some cases, fusion can occur in a thin region around the core called cells. A star in its life converts hydrogen into helium, helium to carbon, and other heavier elements like oxygen, argon, etc. And all these processes occur in different parts of its core. But for every star, a point will come when the gravitational pull cannot keep the fusion growing, and the fusion will stop. And when fusion stops, for most of the stars, it's over. Since the fusion is not keeping any outward pressure in the star, the gravity will contract the star about the size of an earth. The star will become extremely hot, and hot matter glows. This is the white dwarf star. The white dwarf will then slowly cool down. It will take few billions to trillions of years before it cools down to the ambient temperature and become a black ball of cold matter. This is known as black dwarf stars. The size of a white dwarf star is very, very small, but it can be extremely massive. The maximum mass of a white dwarf star can be 1.4 solar mass. This upper boundary on white dwarf mass is given by Chandrasekhar, and we call this the Chandrasekhar's limit. The white dwarf stars are extremely massive, so the gravity will try to contract it. But at one point of time, Pauli's exclusion principle will kick in and save the star. Pauli's exclusion principle is a quantum mechanical phenomena. This basically says that any two identical particles cannot stay in same place at same time. In a white dwarf star, temperature is so high that all the electrons will strip apart from their atom, and then gravity will contract those electrons so densely that it will run out of Pauli's exclusion principle. This is known as the degenerate electron pressure. Now, white dwarf stars are very, very small. Their brightness is also very low. So how do you detect the white dwarf stars? The one way of detecting white dwarf star is the back and forth motion of some star. If there is a back and forth motion of some star in the sky, then we can say that there is a companion star and this is a binary star system. If that companion star is not visible, then we can say that the companion star is a black hole. But in most of the cases, we can see a very dim companion star. These are the white dwarf stars. In fact, the brightest star in the night sky, Sirius, also has a white dwarf companion star. We call it Sirius B. There is another way of detecting a white dwarf star. When the fusion stops in a star, the core of the star is mostly carbon or oxygen, and the gravity cannot fuse them. But gravity will contract the star. So in some cases, it happens that a thin shell of helium atoms around the core start fusing. This is known as helium shell burning. This process creates a shockwave around the star, and it throws away lots of its mass in the space. Then this matter is shined by the starlight in a brilliant way. These are known as planetary nebula. The name is a misnomer. It has nothing to do with planets. The name was actually given by William Herschel hundreds of years back. He actually thought that these look like planets. So whenever we can see a planetary nebula in sky, then there is a very high possibility that there is a white dwarf star in its center. The white dwarf star will shine for trillions of years, but this video must end. So thank you.